Hello, in this short clip I'm going to just show how I based the triangle piece for traditional English paper piecing, patchwork quilting. I'm working on this block, which looks something like a Roman paving from a church or cathedral, dark squares and light squares that meet at angles. And so it's a block where I'll be joining triangles and squares and straight edges and squares of different sizes, like the small ones in the corner. So for this block I need to baste some triangles, and it's very similar to the square. You need your piece of fabric, your piece of paper, which is not too thick, thicker than copy paper maybe, but not too thick, and your piece of fabric with its quarter inch seam. And in basting a triangle, I like to start with the long edge of the triangle. I've got my needle where, like you saw in the other clip, I've married the thread and I have a knot at the end of the thread. I start with the long edge of the triangle, fold it over and crease it down. Bring the needle through from underneath up. Pull the needle through till the knot is snug at the back. Go down through again to hold the fabric in place whilst I fold the second edge, using my fingernail to make sure that the seam is creased right to the corner of the triangle. Fold the second edge, crease it down. So that gives me this little tail that sticks out. Push my needle through, and the important thing is to come up through all the layers of the fabric in the very corner. Pinch that corner, turn it round, pinch the edge, bring the needle through, back through the middle of the edge. Obviously it's not this awkward when you're doing it. It's a bit awkward for me because I'm trying to face the camera. Once the needle's through, the fabric is held, so I can fold down the corner, the 45 degree corner of the triangle. Push the needle through, bring it back up through all the layers to keep the corner tight. End of the needle back through, and this is the not tricky bit, but the important bit to do carefully. Push the needle through, and then the last corner, the tail's going to go in the same direction. So open up that corner, take the long straight edge and just crease it down again, making sure that the seam is creased right to the edge of the triangle, and then fold the two seams over so that they meet in that corner. Squeeze it down, fingernail, bring the needle through, up in the middle of the edge, down, right through the corner, so that you're going through all the layers. Then back up in the middle of the bottom. Then you can snip off, and your piece should look like a little cat's head with the two tails pointing in the same direction. And the advantage of that is that when you join your pieces, if you're making a harlequin square with the four triangles, you can see when you push your triangles together to sew, the tails are not getting in each other's ways. They're all sticking outwards. And when you have folded down your triangular piece, you can see these nice little sharp corners. Right in the corner is where your needle is going to go when you're joining these pieces. And if you are going to sew that triangle with a square, then you want to put your square right into that corner. And you can see how the square sits on the two little tails or flaps. But of course, to sew them, you're going to put the corners together with the pieces back to back corner meeting corner, and you can fold the flap out of the way, and I'll illustrate the joining of the pieces as that block moves ahead. So this little clip is really just to show you how to baste a triangular piece when you're patchwork quilting with English paper piecing.